In this video, we will be learning about the reconciliation process that happens on the WebGST panel. In previous video, we have already learned about the WebGST filing process. So with your login credentials, sign in onto the platform. As soon as you sign in, you will land on the dashboard page, which you have already seen. Now we'll move on to the reconciliation tab. So on the left-hand side, you will find the reconciliation tab, where various options such as GSTR2 versus 2A, 6 versus 6A, and others you can see on the screen. We'll start with GSTR2 versus 2A RICO. Here you'll find three submenus. First of all, reconciliation summary, invoice data correction, and finally reconciliation. You can start with reconciliation summary. Here you can perform a reconciliation either date-wise or period-wise. I'll be selecting period and select one of the period as. And I'll select one of my GSTN number. And for supplier name, I'll select all as of now and click on view details. This will take about a minute to load since I'm loading a 6 months data over here. So already the data has been loaded. Here you can find GSTR2 data, that is your purchase data, and GSTR2A data, that is your supplier's sales data. So ideally this should match, but if in case this is not matching, you can go below and see the reconciliation status as well, where you can see the number of matching invoices, number of missing invoices in supplier's data, number of missing invoices in your data, and the mismatch invoices as well. So if you're not satisfied with the data, you can go into the reconciliation. Here, you'll find a much more detailed summary where you can find the number of matching invoices, missing invoices in supplier's data, missing invoices in your data, the number of mismatch invoices, the invoices you can keep on hold as well, and the reconciliation status. If you want to see the details of each and every invoice, then you can click on view details. So I like to see the missing invoices in subs data. So I clicked on supplier's invoice missing. Here, I get to see the missing invoices in GSTR2A. There are various options available, like accept invoices, which will add them to GSTR2A, reject, which will delete the invoices from GSTR2, hold, which will keep these invoices on hold for the next month or the next trimester. And we can even add comments to these invoices. So the use of adding comments is that we can trigger notification to our suppliers using the supplier trigger option. So this will send the data of the missing invoices and the mismatch invoices to the supplier using the GSTN number and the email address of the supplier that we had given in the supplier management. So in this way, it becomes easier for us to do the reconciliation process. We can even see the mismatch invoices. What is mismatching in these invoices? We can click on view details. And here we can see the invoice number is same, invoice date is same, but the invoice value is different in the invoice. The taxable value is also different. Total tax amount is different. So if we see that the data is wrong from our side, then we can edit the items, which will change our site data without actually re-uploading any data. We can directly edit on the system itself. And if again, the mistake is from the supplier side, then we can add comments to the invoice and trigger notification that I explained earlier. Now we'll go back. There's another option available in reconciliation, which is the invoice data correction. Here we get multiple filter types such as invoice number, invoice date, invoice number and date both, which will help us to find out invoices which are matching in all respect except the invoice number or invoice date or invoice number and date both, and the rest of the filters as well. So here, these are the invoices which are matching in all respect except the invoice number, such as here you can see. So we can either accept these invoices from GSTR2 to 2A, she'll automatically send them into the matching section. So this is also another way to perform invoice data correction. And there's one more setting available in the settings menu for reconciliation, that is tolerance. So we have amount adjust up to rupees 50. Invoices automatically with a difference of up to rupees 50 can be sent into the matching section. So that completes our reconciliation demo of the Web GST panel. Thank you.